Hello! Today's topic will be choosing the proper module in Revolution and how to connect to a 1280 indicator using Ethernet TCP/IP. First of all, to know what Revolution module to use, we need to know the firmware version of our indicator. There are multiple ways of doing this, from sending the version EDP command to going into configuration. For this video, we will go into configuration to find out what version of firmware our 1280 is using. To start, proceed to the menu button in the upper left corner of the screen. When you push it, you will then proceed to the option titled Configuration. Once you have entered configuration, you can look to the bottom of the screen. Here it says Firmware Version, which is followed by a number. My firmware version is 1.10, which, at the time of this recording, is the most recently released firmware version. Keep your number in mind, because you will need it for selecting your Revolution module. Now, because I want to connect my 1280 over the network, I will ensure that there is an Ethernet cable plugged into the port of the 1280. After confirming that my Ethernet cable is secured, I will make sure the 1280 can take advantage of the network, but also that it can obtain its own IP address without me needing to type one in. So I will proceed to the Communications tab. Under Communications, I will select the Ethernet section, and once its subparameters pop up, I will flip the Enabled slider from off to on. In order to obtain an IP address automatically, I will leave DHCP set to on. When installing a 1280 at a customer's site, make sure to find out if they want the 1280 to have a statically set address or not, because if they want to designate an IP number for the 1280, you will have to set DHCP to off and set the address yourself. I will now proceed to the icon in the lower left corner and proceed to save and exit. Since I was set to DHCP, I want to check what my IP address was. I could go back into configuration to find this out, but it is easier to proceed to the Wi-Fi symbol in the upper right corner of the screen to open the network information section. Here, I can see the IP address that I will need to type into Revolution in order to connect to the 1280. Now that I know my firmware version and IP address, I can proceed to Revolution. I will open Revolution and then click the New button in the upper left corner of the screen. Once you click that button, you will have a multitude of options to choose from. If you don't see the version you need here, you may have an older version of software and should get the latest from www.ricelink.com or by contacting technical support. Since the firmware version I had was 1.10, I will select the 1.07 Plus, which is all 1280 indicators, which are firmware version 7 or higher. By the time you watch this video, that may have changed. Make sure to check on ricelink.com for any further updates. After making sure that 1280 1.07 Plus is highlighted, I will click OK, which will open the 1280 version 107 Plus module. Now that we have the module open, it is time to choose our connection method. Proceed up to the Tools button and then select Options. Since I want to use the network connect to the 1280, I will select the TCP/IP Network Radio button. Once that is selected, I will click OK. There are now two options I have for connecting to the indicator. I could either proceed to the Communications button and then select Connect, or I can click the symbol with two green dots on a wavy line, which also pertains to connecting to a device. I will choose the latter of the options. When I click the button, I will get a new prompt due to the fact that I have TCP/IP network selected as my connection option. The port will default to 10001, but if you have changed your server's port number on the 1280, you will need to match that here. Here is where you will type in the IP address that you checked earlier in the network information section. I will type in the IP address of my 1280 and then click the Go button. It should say Connected in the status area of the Connect to Indicator box. If you do not see this message, or any others because the box went away, that just means it connected successfully, so it got rid of the Connect to Indicator box. If you get an error message though, you will want to go back and confirm three main points. Confirm you have the right indicator module, that you are using the right port number for your 1280, and finally, make sure that you typed in the correct IP address. If all three of these things appear correct to you, please contact Rice Lake Weighing Systems Technical Support for more assistance. That concludes our segment of selecting the proper module in Revolution and using it to connect to your 1280. Thank you for your time.